Hello friends, I'm Dashin Kumar Das. Once again, welcome back to our YouTube channel Shadow Bites. Finally, after a gap of over 1 month, I'm back with another video, and this time the video will be slightly different from our regular videos because in this video I'll be testing a sub 22k rupees laptop, which is Lenovo Thinkpad X270, which is this right in my hand. You can see this laptop, it is Lenovo Thinkpad X270. Now why I am saying sub 22k price, because this laptop's actual price is 18,399 on Amazon, but as it came up with only 8GB RAM, so later I had upgraded the RAM to 16GB, thereby replacing the existing 8GB RAM with the new 16GB RAM, as because this laptop comes with only a single RAM slot, thus it cost me 3000 rupees extra. Also, I had bought Antsports GM80 gaming mouse for this laptop, which again cost me another 300 rupees, and another 300 rupees I have spent for buying the USB hub. Besides laptops, these two things are also important because some of you may not be comfortable enough with the touchpad and the USB hub is necessary because this laptop comes with only two USB ports. One is this side, I don't know whether you can see or not, this side, another is this side. So this one. So two USB port may not be enough for many of you, so I decided to push the budget slightly above so that you can buy other necessary things as well. Also, I have bought the gaming mouse because later I will do a gaming benchmark test on this laptop as well on my first channel Smart Tech Magics. Now talking about the specification of this laptop, first of all, let me say one thing, this is a refurbished laptop. You can see from the back end that this is a refurbished laptop which I bought from Amazon. So Best Buy link to buy this laptop will be given in the description below, from where you can buy it directly. And even I have bought this gaming mouse for 300 rupees from Amazon only. And the USB hub, you can buy it from Amazon, no problem. But I have bought this USB hub from our logo at 300 rupees from our local computer store. So anyways, now let's talk about the specification of this laptop. Regarding the specification of this laptop comes with small 12.5 inch Full HD display, and it's powered up by Intel Core i5-7300U processor. Basically, i5 7th generation processor, and the 7th generation processor is the minimum requirement for Windows 11. So you can easily run Windows 11 on this laptop. If it doesn't give update automatically from Windows 10, then simply you just put Windows 11 bootable USB drive and you can easily upgrade to Windows 11. And it also comes with TPM 2.0 security chip, so you can easily upgrade it to Windows 11, no problem, as because you know that 7th generation processor is the minimum requirement for Windows 11. And talking about the ports, it comes with two USB ports, which I have said just now, one this side, one is this side, and another is on this side, this one. And one USB type A ports, by the way, two USB ports, which I am saying about USB type A port, one USB type C port, one single cooler fan, and one Ethernet port, which is most probably, I forgot the term, maybe it is said RJ45 jack, and one SD card slot, which is this one, this one SD card slot, and one 3.5 mm headphone jack, which is my jack as well. And this is all about ports and buttons, and so yeah. And but it comes with two batteries. This is the first time I am seeing myself that a laptop is having two batteries. One is removable battery, which is this one, and another is non-removable, which is placed here. If you open the laptop, then only you can see the battery. So yeah, This was all about the specification of this laptop. Now let me tell you the backstory for buying this laptop. I mean, why I have bought this laptop. I will tell you that thing only. So guys, recently I was for you guys, I was planning to make a video of best laptop for coding under 20,000 budget, and my criteria was to best possible coding. You need at least 16 GB of RAM, at least i5 6th gen or 7th gen processor. Preferably I was searching for 7th gen processor, because 7th gen processors are the minimum requirements for Windows 11, so that you can enjoy the latest Windows on your laptop, and 16 GB RAM. By the way, if you want to have a 16 GB RAM and 512 GB SSD under 22,000 with best possible processor, then you can also do a small sacrifice. That is, in that case, you need to have a i5 6th gen processor laptop, which is Lenovo thing, which again comes with Lenovo refurbished laptop only. Most probably, it was the Lenovo ThinkPad L260, as far as I can remember. Yes, ThinkPad L260, which size is slightly bigger, 14-inch FHD display, and this is more compact, as it is size is only 12.5 inch. And by the way, it is a thin, and I will definitely say it's a very lightweight laptop. Maybe its weight is somewhere around 1.3 to 1.5 kg max to max, and you can easily carry it with one hand. And if you want to carry it on your back, then your shoulder will not pain at all, because this is quite light laptop. So basically what I want to say is, I was searching for a laptop which will be compact, which you can easily carry anywhere, having a good battery life, and also it should have what processors I have just now said, and that too under 20,000. But if you see the latest 20,000 laptops, then you can see that those laptops has lots of sacrifices, and the main sacrifice is the processor. The most of the 20,000 latest laptops come with Celeron processor, which is really a pathetic and slow processor. I won't recommend anyone to buy those laptops with Celeron processor, especially if you are planning to run Windows on it. Now I talk too much, so let's start the coding benchmark of this laptop. So now let's move to this laptop screen. Okay, so now I'm in the laptop screen. So as you can see that here, sorry, I'm just talking something stupid. Anyways, what I want to say is that in this laptop, I will be testing two cores. Thumbnail of those cores you can see right here. One is face recognition based entrance monitoring system using Python, and another code is also Python based project, which is object detection using assist. Now I have already made videos of how to run this code in one, which is this one, face recognition based entrance monitoring system. I have made on this channel, and object detection using assist I have made on my previous channel, Smart Tech Magics. Both of these videos links will be given in the description below, and also I will in the description I will give the link to download these codes. Anyways, it's time to test this code and see how fast this laptop is able to run the code smoothly. So yeah, let's jump into the code. Okay, so show the codes. Thing is here. Yes, no, it's not here. Yeah, it's here in the downloads folder. Okay, so now it's time to run these codes. Let's open IDLE Python 3.11. By the way, I have already installed these modules in command prompt. So yeah, let's start. IDLE, okay, fine. So it takes some time, one to two seconds to open this basic Python software. Now let's click on open. Okay, let's see from all the angles. Anyways, let's click on open. Now let's move this point. Okay, downloads, page generation project, main.py. Okay, so fine. Now you can simply click on F5 or rather click on run module. The code should run absolutely fine. It's taking some time. Okay, within approximately 5 seconds, this interface opens. Okay, typing my ID, typing my name. Typing my name. Now let's click on take images. Let's see how fast the camera opens. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, it took 10 seconds to open the camera. It's taking enough images. It will take hundreds of images, as I so told in my first video of this channel Shadowbytes, also in my previous channel's videos. Now click on save profile, password, same GIX magic. Profile saved successfully. Now let's click on take attendance. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It took 8 seconds to open the attendance portion. Low light, or anyways, it's taking the attendance perfectly, no problem. Now press Q. By the way, I have also made a modified version of this code where you don't need to press Q, but the small disadvantage of that code is you can't, it will take attendance within the blink of an eye and the attendance will be saved. And if there is no person or wrong person, then the camera will freeze. In that case, you need to press cross. So, I mean, you need to click on cross to stop it. Anyways, that's other topic. If you want, I will make a modified version video code, so no problem. Let's see if the attendance is saved or not. Okay, fine. By the way, before that, let's see training image folder. See all my images is stored. 101 images. Anyways, let's tell you a story. Student details. See details stored. Attendance. So attendance is also taken. By the way, it's 9:145. Let's see. Anyways, let's run the code again. Some decadence. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 seconds into. Okay. On 9 seconds. 9 to 10 seconds it takes to open the attendance. Open the camera basically. Even in the time of taking the new registration, it took nearly 10 seconds to open the camera. Anyways, okay, fine. Everything is working absolutely fine. I will not look at the second attendance again. It's already displayed here. Okay, now let's run the next code. Running the next code is also as easy as this one. This one. Let's open the different code and run it. By the way, let me save a brief introduction of this second code before running it. This code basically detects objects from a video footage, and the video footage in this case, the video is saved as text. Not in this case only, in every case, if you are using this particular code without doing any sort of changes, then this will you have to save in video which where you want to detect the objects using this text dot mp4. Wait a minute. Yes, you have to just rename it as test.mp4, then only the image video will detect. Let's play the video. It's taking time. Okay, this is the video. Took around 3 to 4 seconds to open the media player. Anyways, this is the video on which the objects will be detected during the execution of the code. You don't need to see the full video, so let's jump into the code. Running the code. I'm pressing F5. Operate will work within 3 seconds. Nearly within 3 seconds, the live detection chart. Let's see how much it's live detected. It's sitting fine. The code is working fine even in this laptop. So yeah, it's running fine. You can easily, you can blindly trust this laptop for coding. See, now if you are here for doing Android development, Android app development or something like that, then also this laptop might help you. But I don't know how to do Android development. For that you have to consult with my channel partner Meban. He is good at Android development. Not only that, he also made some games using Unity software. I think our mission is over. It's close. Stands is 7.65. Approx FPS 16.56. Everything is written here. So yeah, this is it. So this is this. It took this much time to run both of these codes. As you can see, it's quite good. Let's do some more small test. Let's open AutoCAD and see how fast it opens. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. It took around 11 seconds to load the first page and another 5 to 6 seconds, nearly 7, 8 seconds, 9, 10. Okay. It took nearly 10 seconds to open the first page and another 10 seconds to open the second one. So yeah, AutoCAD is open. You can see still not open. Overall, it took nearly 20 seconds to open AutoCAD, which is quite okay, I believe. By the way, very soon I will make an AutoCAD, basic AutoCAD tutorial video on this channel. So if you are interested in AutoCAD, then also you can subscribe this channel, because beside coding, I will teach AutoCAD also. Because as I said in my first video, that all engineering projects tutorial will be covered here. I believe the AutoCAD tutorial will be helpful to many engineering students beside coding. Anyways, it took around 20 to 25 seconds to launch AutoCAD. Okay. Let's open one MATLAB. I will make MATLAB tutorial video also later on. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 7, 8, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 8, 9, 60, means 1 minute, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 68, 69, 70. So yeah, it took around 70 seconds to open this software. As you can see, MATLAB opens in 70 seconds, which means 1 minute 15 to 1 minute 10 to 15 seconds it took. So yeah, that's it. We are towards the end of this video. I have said that I will do only coding test, but I do some bonus test as well to show you how this laptop is capable of doing all engineering project works. By the way, it is the near latest version of MATLAB. If you run older version of MATLAB, then it will launch even faster. AutoCAD is in the memory. Everything is in the memory. Anyways, so yeah, that's it. This is the end of the coding test of this Lenovo ThinkPad X270 laptop. which is having i5-7300U processor paired with 16GB RAM and 512GB SSD. As you can see that before ending, let me say one thing. As you can see, I have installed 7 games, so I will test all these 7 games in my Smart Tech Magic YouTube channel. So if you want to say the gaming test of this laptop, although this is not a gaming laptop at any sense, still if you want to see the gaming test of this laptop, then you can definitely subscribe my first channel Smart Tech Magics, because there I will upload the game benchmarking video of this laptop. So yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching. If you like this video and find this video helpful and informative, then please hit the like button. Like target is only 50. Please help us to complete our target. And if you haven't subscribed our channel, then please subscribe it and tap the bell icon beside it, and on the bell icon select all to watch our latest videos before anyone else. So once again, thanks for watching. See you soon in our next video. Basically it will be AutoCAD tutorial video that I have said just now. Anyways, see you soon in our next video. Until then, stay happy, stay safe, and goodbye.
We are heroes tonight.